What up, what up, what up? Welcome to another edition of An Uncomfortable Truth. And this podcast, like many others in the Groove TV family, is brought to you by the Power of Five. Like, comment, subscribe, notify, and share. Doing those five things will help us reach more and more people and hopefully make the world a better place. And now, without any further ado, we're going to get on to the topic of the program, which is women aren't as dumb as we think. It's kind of self-explanatory, but I think that a lot of people in this space and the way they talk about women, well, and I guess in a negative sort of way, but they're talking to them like they're kids, they're juvenile. They don't know any better. I'm here to tell you the opposite. Women know exactly what they're doing. They like to play dumb, but they know. For example, let's start on the opening salvo in the dating scene. The initial meeting of two people, a male and a female. Men approach women with the end result of having sex. Women know within the first few minutes, at the maximum 5 minutes, if you're going to be successful or not. Because, as has been said in this and many other podcasts, women control sex. They're the gatekeepers to sex. If they don't want you in, you ain't getting it. It is what it is. And because women hold the gateway to sex, they wield enormous power. Men's power comes on the back end. After you have sex with a woman, let's look at it, let's be totally 100% honest here. Today's dating marketplace is meeting, sex, relationship. That's the way it is now. It never used to be that way, but it is now. And we as men have to adapt to survive and thrive in the new environment. So after the sex, a man's propensity then, for the most part, shuts off. He is feasted, so to speak. He's on to the next one. Unless the woman that he has had relations with demonstrates that she's more than just a one-night stand, that she adds value to him, at which time he then takes a second and third look with the end result of being serious committed relationship with the end result of probably being marriage. That's the way things are today. And you'd be hard-pressed to see it any other way. Can you? Yes. It's like we say all the time. There are always exceptions to every rule that is out. Every rule. But that doesn't make them fact. That doesn't make it a given. Remember also, women tend to deal with possibilities. Men tend to deal with probabilities. A woman, she's thinking, he may be a bad boy, but if I get him, I can change him. And he'll become the man I've always wanted. Conversely, a male's thinking, I'd love to hit it, but there's too many red flags. And I stand a real big chance of being burnt, so I won't bother. It is what it is. And if you deal with things in a probability as opposed to a probability, you save a lot of this. And that's a danger that you don't want. Remember, to successfully navigate the dating marketplace, and we'll say dating from this point forward because it includes sex, because as we established earlier, the pathway to marriage is introduction, sex relationships, committed relationships, engagement, and marriage. That's the way it goes today. Excuse me, I'm really fumbling my words today. Excuse me for this, but that's the way it's going. That's what is normally happening. And again, it is what it is. Women, as I stated before, women like to play dumb. That's not up for debate. That's not me thinking. That is hard anecdotal evidence that supports what I'm saying. Sort of like, I think it was Superman 1, the movie, with Christopher Reeves and Gene Hackman. And there's a woman, ditzy as anything. And when she finds what's going on, all of a sudden, she sounds incredibly intelligent. And that was her all along. And that thought there brings to mind a very important question that a lot of guys will ask. And that is, if she's that intelligent, why play stupid? It's because society has dictated to today's woman that they don't want smart. Or at least they did. Now in this new economy, all bets are off. But women didn't back then weren't appreciated for their brains, just their beauty. Is it right? No. Is it fair? No. Is it kind? Hell no. But it is what it is. And in a course of overcompensating, adjusting to make up for that supposed fallacy, we've gone the exact opposite way, where women are celebrated for their intelligence and men are demonized. Classic examples: The Simpsons, Family Guy. In The Simpsons, Homer, the male of the house, is an abject idiot. Marge is the same cool, calm, and collected person who holds the family together. Family Guy. Family Guy, I said, not American Dad, Family Guy. Well, this is in the same vein. The man's an idiot, the woman holds it together. And that started in the early to mid 90s. That's when this whole feminism thing broke. And that's when people really started to come on board with it. I don't have a dog in this fight. I honestly could care less. I have reached a point in my existence that I'm going to do for me and mine. I'm going to impart wisdom when I can. And the rest of it is just, it just is. King Riches, shout out to you, King Riches, and everyone at the Just Pearly Things Network, likes to say that he doesn't care, and he likes to say that he does what he does, and it just, and you can take it or leave it. That's how I look at things these days. I'm going to tell you what it is that's happening. I'm like the old time news programs. We give you the facts. No spin, no fluff, just the facts. And then we leave it to you to take that information, digest it, think about it, marinate on it, and then act on it as you see fit. Because that's the way an informed society should work. That's how it should work. Now you've got all these opinion things, these opinion shows and things like that, that tell you how they think and how you should think. But that's not how we do things here. It doesn't matter what we think. That's why a long time ago, I decided to not give advice. For the most part, I mean, there are still times where I may suggest something. But for the most part, I don't like giving advice simply because if it goes wrong, you're blamed for it. I did what you said. And it's all messed up now. And it's all your fault. Not thinking that maybe, just maybe, you missed a step or two along the way. Because, let's face it, a lot of times you can follow something in the hopes of having a positive outcome. And in your zeal to get there, you miss a step or two. You overshadow, overlook it, and things go differently. And the first thing you want to do is say, well, you told me to. No, I didn't tell you to. I told you to do A, B, C, and D. You did A, E, G, and so on and so forth. So I don't give advice. I don't try to teach you. I don't try to preach to you. None of that stuff. I'm not an influencer. I'm not a motivational speaker. None of those adjectives apply. Instead, I like to show you a different path. Something else to look at. And you can do it as you see fit. No, doesn't do it, fine. If you don't, that's fine too. At the end of the day, I still get my rest. I know what I know. I'll impart what I know to you. And you do what you want with the rest. That's it. No more, no less. What does that have to do with women, you may ask? Because I think that at the end of the day, when you get down to it, peel away all the extraneous fluff and nonsense, and you have the situation at its root, at the core. Women in general think what they think, act how they act, and do what they do in response to men. We are the victims of our own success, and it's indirectly due to us because we tend to adapt. If the end result of every encounter with a female is to have sex, we will say, think, act, and do whatever it takes to make that reality. Whatever it takes. The men that are better at it than others fall into what I'm going to call the hot four. Money, status, looks, charisma. Those four things. Four things. And it don't have to be all that four. If you can mix and match and get at least two, you're doing better than most. You got three, all right. Four, look out. And I've heard women complain about men lead with money. But men don't lead with money. Simps deal with money. And I'm using the word simps because in this context, I want to use it as men who do whatever it takes, go above and beyond to satisfy a woman, hoping for a return, but getting nothing in return. They are the inverse of the change woman. If I just hold on, I can change him. That's female. Males, if I take her out, if I wine her and dine her, if I buy her things, she may like me. Truth be told, neither one of those situations work. Or if they do, it's so, so rare that it's statistically insignificant. Brings to mind the old saying, if a tree falls in the woods and nobody hears it, does it fall? Yes, it does fall, but nobody hears it. So in terms of the total forest, it's insignificant. You can honestly say no, because you didn't hear it. Excuse me. You didn't hear it. There's no obvious sign of wear and tear. So for all intents and purposes, it didn't fall. In all actualities, yes, it did. If you go looking for it, you'll find it eventually. But like most people, beyond a cursory inspection, oh, it's not here. Don't worry about it. It didn't fall. I say all that to say this. Women are conniving. They're manipulating. they're gaslighting. All those toxic traits that they say men do to them, they do to us. Women would ghost a guy before ghosting was even a thing. Call a girl on the phone once, have a little talk, inconsequential, basic chitter chatter. Never hear from her again. You've been ghosted by today's standards. But I'm going back to a time when there was no internet. None. I'm going back to a time when there were four major channels and three minors. And that's it. I'm going back to a time where I'm going back to a time when everything was fresh and new and different and lovely and every other positive adjective you can come up with. Women aren't as dumb as we think they are. Oh, they'll let you think so. They'll keep up the charade for as long as they think as long as they need to. And once it's until it no longer serves their needs. And that's the MO for a lot of women these days. They do things for as long as it benefits them, and once it doesn't, it's on to the next. And we have society to thank for that. Where does it change? How does it change? What can one do? What can we do as men to combat this? Well, there are several things we can do. The first thing is just ignore the whole thing. And it's to be a matter of mind over matter, where we don't mind and they don't matter. MGTOW, men going their own way. I'm going to do me over there. They're going to stay over there. And we're going to be happy. We could do that. We can do what we've been doing for time immemorial, which is adapt. See which way they're going and try and get ahead of it. Optimally. But realistically, see where it's headed and roll with the punches. I'm doing a lot of shrugging because it is what it is. We as a people have gone down this rabbit hole. Eyes wide open. Knowing this is not going to end well. Knowing this, and we do it anyway. But there's MGTOW, there is adapting to it, and there's leaving it alone. There probably are variations on those three, but those are the three primary things that we as men can do to combat this. To keep our sanity in an ever increasingly insane world. There are there's two separate videos from two different people. When Nate's got keys in one London. And they're all about gold diggers. They got the nice cars. They're trying to talk. Well, they're outside the car. They're trying to talk to this woman. Women ignore them until they see what they're driving. And then they come running back. And then they get dissed. You can't make this up. And why do women do it? Well, women do it because at first they're turned off by this person for whatever reason. See what he has, and then very quickly deduce, if I can get with him, I can get that. Which is money and a nice ride. That's why every time you turn on one of those videos, they're always talking about going shopping, getting a new bag, going out to expensive restaurants to eat. And they always tell you the same thing. It's not my money. It's your money. What's mine is mine. What's yours is mine. Shout out to the late, great Heavy D from Heavy D and the Boys. And his classic answer is, I got nothing but love for you. Nothing. If my love's not enough to keep you warm, get to stepping. Get to stepping. As Nate likes to say, have a nice walk. It is what it is. And we come to the end of another one. But before we go, there are a couple of things I want to discuss with you real quick. First one is that I want to apologize to my viewers for the erratic posting of videos. There's been a lot of people here at the lab. Things have been identified and being addressed. And we'll get back to regularly scheduled programming in the next week or so. So I apologize to one and all for that. And I want to take this time right now to thank everyone who has liked it, who has commented, who subscribed, who sent notification, who shared. Things that people do because they want to rock with you. Thank you for your continued love and support. And we're just about on our final stages of a major launch. Keep it locked in here because we'll be going live very, very soon. We might even go live for our 100th show. Still debating about that one. But as always, I want to thank you all for tuning in. I want to say thank you all for your love and support, your continued love and support. Stay safe out there. Peace. I'm gone.